This is Otter Pro XT1200 Lodge setup.
Alright, let's go. Let's go. Everything's done except for the panel box. We've got two batteries hooked up in parallel. Mike helped me make this control box here. From those batteries, control box where everything's turned on and off. And then I made this box right here to store all my wires. And I'll show you where those go in a sec. If you look up here, you've got female plugs, these wires run a tube, LED lights, boxing, these things on the way. Plugs right here for the fan. Plug in our fan and run it down this vertical pole. More LEDs. Now I made a space here. I made a space right here so we could have a spot to put this vertical stabilizer. So then I also made the plugs. Instead of running the wires through the poles, I made the plug for the females right here. So originally Mike thought we could put the wires down the pole, but I think since we got the pole moving in and out, this box to hide the wires right now. Then make sure this is shut off. Oh, and then this one. Let's show this. Here's the power to the battery. I made a little holder so you can be disconnected and everything right on the side of the battery mount. All you gotta do is unplug this. But we'll wait. Everything's on. Just gotta make sure everything's operating. So just plug that into the box. Just wrap it up right here. Positive and negative in. That controls one of the lights, which is on one of the switches. That light and this light, they're both on separate switches. We still need banana plugs. Me and Mike customized this fan, took out a switch. It was a two-way switch for high and low settings on the fan. Took that switch out, we direct wired it to the motor, then we wired in a, gosh, I butchered this word, what do you call it?
It's a potentiometer.
Yeah, we wired a potentiometer for the fan so we can turn it up and down right here. And then since that temp, whatever that word is, since we can't, when you go all the way down, it doesn't turn off. We wired a separate switch so we can turn it on.
What's down beneath that tension?
Oh, and right here, we have an accessory outlet. So if I want to charge my phone or something while I'm out here, you can do that or hook whatever else up. Then also, what we'll be able to do, I silicone the battery terminals to the, I just wanted everything waterproof. But what we did is, what you can do is hook up your charger to the AC outlet on the wall and have your plug that goes in here, wire it up to your charger, and I guess we can put the plug in there and charge our batteries through a AC all the way down the wall. Let me hook this up. This will go a lot faster if I had those banana plugs. But... should work. Let's just see if the fan works. Okay, it works. Just testing it. Can you turn the heat on? What did you say it was outside, Mike?
Minus 11 today.
Minus 11. Let's see how fast we can keep this thing. I have it on high. And, yeah, maybe a little light change. Okay, this is with everything closed, there's daylight outside. This is lights over our head.
Yeah, but we can fix that. This is our first trial run of everything outside, so there is a couple bugs to work out, but didn't have any issues with the electrical when we hooked everything up for the first time. All the switches worked, batteries didn't get hot.
We also wired a fuse into the control box, so if anything does, there's too much voltage, and if it's overpowered, it'll blow that fuse and we won't ruin anything in there. And I also covered everything in silicone. Inside that box, I put a cap of silicone in there. It's not conductive, so it won't do anything. Yeah. Wish I could handle this down. I'm just curious how long it'll take to get really warm in here.
Plenty of light with those LEDs. Way better than the rope lights that you can purchase from Shields that are made for ice fishing. These were actually ones sold by Radio Shack for applications as far as under vehicles or outside.
And they're waterproof. They encase the lights with like rubber material. But you can cut the LEDs every three lights. There's little positive negative terminals there. And you just got a solder wire on there. And I, like I said, I put everything in silicone. Or not silicone, but I use epoxy. So the lights won't move and everything's waterproof. I hope.
Definitely feel the heat circulating in here.
Those two batteries, I ran that fan all night during the silicone. I ran the lights for maybe an hour, and the batteries never got hot. And I don't know how much charge I have, but I'm guessing there will be sufficient power there to run your lights all day and run the fan all day. I'm sure, because these LEDs are low power.
wearing a hooded sweatshirt and coveralls and some pretty good insulated boots. And I could possibly already take off my hooded sweatshirt. That's it. That's pretty good. For minus 11, cold,
yeah,
but
I don't
North
see
Dakota.
Us needing a bigger heater, honestly. I mean, we're going to be bundled up anyway. I want to get a couple hooks put right here. That'd be perfect. You know, they sell those clam ones. Hooks are like sideways.
Yeah.
You can just go get the ones at Menards that are those S hooks. Just clip it on there.
Boom.
Boom.
Boom, boom. Cheaper.
Jacket. Done.
Alright, folks, I think this clearly demonstrates the lighting and fan system, how well this unit will heat and stay warm. Any last things you'd like to say, Brady, before we shut her down?
We charge about $100 an hour if anybody else wants this done. It'll take about 10 hours, roughly. So you do the math, you want it done.
It'll
be about $1,000. And you have to buy materials. Sorry.
Awesome. All right, folks, there you go. Otter Outdoors, Brady Sparks, Mike Will. Peace!